Good morning, children. Welcome to today's session. I'm Kalpana, working as JL Zoology in COE, JV Gude. In today's session, we are going to learn about vaccination as well as immunological disorders. Coming to vaccination, it is based on the property of immune system, which is nothing but memory, in which in the vaccination process or immunization process, weakened or inactivated are the proteins which have the antigenic property are injected into the body of the individual, in which antibodies specific to the antigen are produced along with the memory B cells and T cells, and these memory cells are helpful in evoking quick response whenever there is subsequent infection. Coming to the immunological disorders can be classified into four types: immunodeficiency disorders, hypersensitivity disorders, autoimmune disorders, and graft rejections. Coming to the first category, immunodeficiency disorders. Immunodeficiency disorders are resulting due to decrease in the immunological response, and these can be categorized into two categories, primary and secondary. Coming to the primary immunological disorder, which is resulted due to defective genes, and the best example is SCID or severe combined immunodeficiency disorders. And coming to the secondary immunological disorders, and it is resulted due to infection or aging. Best example is human immunodeficiency virus or AIDS. Coming to the AIDS in detail, it is a non-congenital and transmissible and sexually transmitted disease. And the first case of AIDS was reported in 1981 by CDC in US. And coming to the mode of infection, it can be transferred from one person to another person through sexual contact, and also blood transfusion and sharing of infected needles, and from an infected mother to the child. Coming to the structure of the HIV or human immunodeficiency virus, it consists of two strands of single stranded RNA. It consists of two strands of single stranded RNA, and it is a retrovirus, and these RNA molecules are covered by protein molecules, and two molecules of reverse transcriptase enzyme is present. Upon the protein layer, one more protein layer is present, which is surrounded on the whole by a lipid layer. On the surface of the lipid layer, there are glycoproteins, which are known as GP120 and GP41. These are providing sites for the, these are attaching with the receptors which are present in the host cell. And coming to the mechanism of HIV, whenever HIV virus is entering into the host or human beings, these are infecting helper T cells, macrophages and dendritic cells, and the single stranded DNA RNA which is present in the virus is going to be synthesize its complementary single stranded DNA with the help of reverse transcriptase enzyme. Later on, through by autocatalysis, this single stranded DNA molecule is developing it or synthesizing its complementary DNA strand, so that a double stranded DNA is synthesized, and this double stranded DNA is going to be incorporated into the host cell's DNA by the enzyme integrase which is present in the virus itself. Along with the host DNA, the viral DNA is also replicated, and these viral DNA in the process of transcription, it is going to convert into RNA molecule, or in the translation process, it is going to convert into protein substances. These later on assemble and form the viral particles, and they bud off from the infected cell, so that their number is going to be multiplied. In this process, the helper T cells number are going to be decreased, because here macrophages are not decreased, because only particular helper cells are T helper cells are decreased due to presence of CD4 markers, which are acting as receptors for GP41 as well as GP120 molecules. Attack and certain types of cells or tissues by the virus is known as tissue tropism. And coming to the symptoms, there is always a lag period between the entry and appearance of symptoms, and that is known as lag period, and it usually varies from few months to several years, like 5 to 10 years, and symptoms include fever, diarrhea, loss of weight, and also here a number of T helper cells are reduced, so the immunity is reduced, and the person is more susceptible to the secondary infections like mycobacterium, and also parasites like Toxoplasma. And one question, children try to find out what is the technology used for producing vaccines. Thank you, children.